Hello, my name is Markus, and I'm the CEO of ThinkCell. Let me walk you through the new features in ThinkCell 10. ThinkCell 10 has many new features, but for this video, I will focus on the most important ones. Let's start with some exceptionally good news. ThinkCell now runs on the Mac. After several years of development, we have achieved what no other company has done before. We have ported a complex Windows Office add-in to Mac Office without sacrificing functionality. Your license for ThinkCell on Windows is also valid for the Mac. You just go to our Downloads page, download the macOS version, install it on your Mac, and activate it with your existing license key. With ThinkCell 10, you can now freely choose your favorite working environment and have the same great user experience on Mac as well as on Windows. The interface is exactly the same and all features are available. To show you how well all this works, I will do this walkthrough on a Mac. I promise you will forget in a few seconds that this is a completely new platform. What you will notice right away is that we have refreshed ThinkCell's user interface, not only for Mac, but also for Windows. The new colors in the Elements menu are much brighter, and the Context menu offers better contrast. We also use icons instead of dropdowns in the floating toolbar whenever possible. For example, to change the chart type, you now click the corresponding icon, instead of choosing a text from a dropdown. We have also completely reworked the Data Links dialog. It now provides a much better overview of the data links in your presentation by using larger thumbnails, which closely resemble PowerPoint slide sorter. Pending updates are clearly marked on the thumbnails. In ThinkCell 10, it is much easier to multi-select several linked charts, either from a range of slides or from a common source file. Keeping charts in their previous PowerPoint state, manually updating them to their current Excel-driven state, or setting them to automatic update is now as simple as pushing a slider. You can also find the same slider in a linked chart's floating toolbar. And each linked chart shows its Excel source file when selected. In regards to enforcing the same scale on several charts, ThinkCell 10 has taken a big step forward. Before ThinkCell 10, you could already set the same value scale for several charts. But this was just a one-shot action and had to be redone whenever the data in one chart changed. In ThinkCell 10, setting the same scale for several charts is a persistent choice, and ThinkCell will automatically adjust all scales whenever your data changes. This even works for charts that have axis breaks. So, when you add a break to one chart that has the same scale as another chart, the break will be added to the second chart as well. Try it yourself with any number of charts and breaks and see how magical this is. Also, in ThinkCell 10, you can use the same scale function on data-based x-axes and on scatter and bubble charts. Next, I will quickly show you some more new useful features. In ThinkCell 10, you can reverse value axes. In case of stacked, clustered, and area charts, this will simply flip the chart. In case of scatter and bubble charts, it will actually reverse the axis direction. If your line or combination chart features two value axes, you can reverse one of them to highlight negative correlations between data series. Our new Save Slides dialog now allows you quick access to your favorites folders, such as the desktop. Including the current date and time in the file name has become an option. By the way, with ThinkCell 10, you can now make Google's Gmail your default email program on Windows. The last new feature I'm going to show you is simple, but has been requested for many years. You can now set the font color of any text label to your liking without it being reverted if the background color changes. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please check out our website for more ThinkCell videos. I hope you enjoy ThinkCell 10, and please let us know how you like ThinkCell on Mac.